And hello YouTube, this is Thomas Judge, back once again with another instalment of my ongoing weekly series, Valiant Till the Last, in which I read every single Valiant Deluxe Edition and, in fact, all the other comics as well in the Valiant universe. I'm still struggling with quite a few health issues, but I am nonetheless tracking on, carry on doing this series on a weekly basis, so I will hopefully try to make this a little bit more coherent and upbeat than last week's video. What we're looking at today is X-O Manowar Book 2. So this is the yellow branded era of X-O Manowar, which is the second volume after the 2012 reboot. We've already looked at the first 50 issues of volume 1, which were the first 5 deluxe editions. Then we looked at the rebooted yellow branded version, which is written by Matt Kint. And we looked at the deluxe edition volume 1 last time, and now we're looking at volume 2. The reason I'm doing that quick and slightly tedious overview is because I want to just show you this. This is what we looked at last time, X-O Manowar Book 1. This is what we're looking at this time, book two. Just to clarify, if you have these on your shelf, that's what the spines are going to look like. That's a bit annoying. Partly it's because this is just thicker and contains more issues, but also there's no need for them to have scaled up that logo there to make it slightly, well, mismatched in size. I mean, it's just silly, and it's just slightly poor design. And stuff like that personally just really annoys me. But, you know, maybe it'll bother you, maybe it won't. Either way, I thought I'd flag that in the video. Let's have a look at what we've got going on here in Book 2. In Book 2, we have the cover. This is the new kind of design that they're using for this Matt Kint era of X-O Manowar. On the spine, we have this. Standard spine, Volume 2. This is the second and last volume of this yellow-branded X-O series. And then at the back here, usual blurb and pictures. Okay, on the inside we've got the usual French flaps. We've got the blurb in the front, navy end leaves, and the blurbs on the back for the creator, so absolutely standard there. Let's have a look under the DJs. You're going to have this raw on your shelf. Instead of the previous one, which was black, this is a navy blue. Again, X-O Manowar blocked in gold, looking nice. And okay, there we are. That's what the spine is, nice and clean. And a nice clean back. Alright, let's dive into this. This is a little bit slimmer than the previous volume. So this is book two. Very straightforward. It contains three arcs, which are respectively arcs Barbarians, Agent and Hero. Barbarians is issue 15 to 18, Agent is 19 to 22, and Hero is 23 to 26. And then it has some behind the scenes stuff as well. Okay, this is the start of the first arc, Barbarians. There are the four covers. So I'll just flick through this. What I'll point out is that Barbarians, this four issue arc, almost the entirety of it is a flashback to X-O Manowar, or rather Arik, in his original life before the armour, so back in the 4th century BC, 4th century AD. It's a decent story. In many ways, it's quite tonally different to the last volume. Now, what I mentioned in the last volume is that it felt like that hardcover, the start of Kint's arc, kind of neglected the fact that Arik was a Visigoth and that was a man out of time. It really had him more as a man out of space, as a human on an alien planet. Whereas this story very much focuses on the historic aspect of him and sort of the nature of him as a man lost in time, and nature of him as a man from a different era. So I thought that was quite interesting. It's almost as if it directly addressed my concerns from the last volume. What I will point out is that this entire thing, as a result, because all four issues are related to kind of a retrospective and a flashback, none of it is happening in the current day, which is interesting because I think during the publication of these issues, this was when Harbinger Wars 2 was coming out. And as we saw at the end of the last deluxe edition, it ends with a little note saying to be continued in Harbinger Wars 2. But X-O Manowar really has a kind of a nominal role in that. He's not hugely involved. And so it feels like rather than trying to have a tie-in or crossover or anything like that, they just decided to take a moment to have a breather and to just kind of have like a retrospective filler story with X-O Manowar while the events of Harbinger's Wars is going on. The one notable thing about this part of the story is that it does introduce this new character who we've never seen before, and to be honest, never really see again as far as I'm aware. But that, if you want to look at anything which is the sole purpose of this entire four issue story arc, Barbarians, it is to introduce this dude. Is he a psyot? He's something, but we'll find out. Then we have the next arc, which is Agent. So Agent is these four issues, you can see the covers here. Now, it does have a Meanwhile in Harbinger Wars 2, which gives you a blurb telling you all the events of Harbinger Wars 2, and then this issue, bang, starts straight after it. So really, the entire Barbarians arc happens contemporaneously with Harbinger Wars 2. You don't need to read Harbinger Wars 2 at all to follow what's going on here. This blurb will tell you everything you need to know, and if you don't read the blurb, you'll still basically be fine. So, with that in mind, what we have here is now a modern day story with Lady Colonel Capshaw, which I actually really enjoyed. I really like her as a character, and just the modern day story and this aspect of it, just really interesting. It's worth noting this entire story, whilst it doesn't feature the character of Divinity, it is about the character of Divinity and the impact of both Divinity and the trilogy of series, and even the Eternity miniseries that followed it as well. So I'm not going to give any spoilers here, but just to say that this all kind of relates to that, and if you haven't read that, this is going to get a little bit confusing to follow for this particular story arc, Agent. But otherwise, good arc, solid story, and the return of some dude called, not these guys, this is all just like backstory and stuff, but it's the return of some dude called David Camp, who is this guy. And when I read the Divinity series, I was like, who is this guy? What's happening with him? Does he become important later on? This is the, I think, to be honest, the only time after the Divinity and Eternity series that I've actually seen him. So that's like, what, 30 odd weeks ago was the last time we read about this character. So it's just a little bit unusual that he comes up in this. But obviously, I've got a good memory. I remember these things. But yeah, so what we have here is a Exo Manor War story which intersects with the Divinity universe. It's pretty interesting. It's pretty good. I enjoyed it. I still feel like it lacks some closure for me, but that's because I generally find the stuff with respect to the Divinity part of this universe a little bit unfulfilling and like it lacks closure, but that's a personal thing. As you can see, artwork is strong. I can say the storyline is pretty good. Dialogue is pretty good. I did enjoy this. What else can I say about this arc? Yeah, the Agent arc is just it's a decent story. And then we move into the Hero arc. So again, the final four issues here. This Hero arc, not much more to say about it. Fantastic cover there, I have to say. Now that should have been the cover for the deluxe edition. Not this thing. That definitely should have been the cover. With that in mind, looking at this and sort of just flicking through the final arc, well drawn, well written, really interesting. A few twists and turns, a few callbacks to the earlier part of the Kint series, so in other words, what we saw in the last deluxe edition. What I will say is this volume, this arc Hero, and in fact this entire second deluxe edition, ends really nicely. It ends with a feeling of closure for Arik as the Visigoth, as Exo Manowar, as a man out of time, as a man out of space, and a man that's sort of an alien to his own world and his own people. And it ends in a nice, kind of heartwarming way. I felt a lot of closure reading the end of this, which I didn't necessarily feel at the end of Volume 5 of the original series, which we sort of went through a few weeks ago. Just because that ended with, oh, he's defeated another threat, and so now the universe is his oyster, and then it kind of ends on issue 50 like that. Whereas this kind of ends very much with a feel of, he's now defeated all the threats he needs to defeat. He's at peace. And he's ready just to rest. And he's found happiness, he's found contentment, that sort of thing. I don't know, maybe that's just me, maybe I'm just projecting, but I did think to myself, I thought this was a nice way for the story to end. And as a result, I'm glad I have this in my collection. It kind of brings a certain circularity and a certain closure to the Manowar series. And then this is the final bit there. Behind the scenes, we've got the usual pencil sketches, DVD style commentary, some extra covers, some deluxe artwork. Good stuff. Can't knock any of it. What I will just say, just to finish off what I was pointing out there, is that there's a fair amount of closure I feel reading the story. What I am conscious of is that there is still more Exo Manowar issues to go. After the Matkind era, after this yellow spined era, there is another era of Manowar that starts, which is a limited maxi series of about 9 issues, which I'm going to be reading for next week. And it's not a deluxe edition, so it's one of those videos where I'll just kind of be talking through the single issues and what I thought of them and so on. But I am entering it with a little bit of trepidation, because I do find myself thinking, does it need to be a story? Is there anything left to say about this? So I don't really know, to be honest. I feel that this volume provides like really decent, really nice closure for the character. Overall, what do I think of Exo Manowar? I like it. I enjoy it. I liked all the crossovers, barring Dead Drop, obviously, which was horrific. And what we'll do next time is we'll talk about the issues that come after this, which is, as I say, the 9-issue limited maxi series. We'll have a chat about that. And then I'll also do what I've done for the previous videos once I've reached the end of certain arcs or families of comics, is I'll look at this reading map that I'm kind of designing and we'll just see where this all fits in. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. As always, please like, comment, subscribe. As always, please follow me on Twitter at IamThomasJudge, where I will post a daily review of whatever comics I've been reading. You can get an idea of what I'm up to on the channel. And as always, please support the channel by heading over to Amazon.com and checking out my prose novel about superheroes. It's a completely original piece of work. The first episode in it is called Arrivals, and the series as a whole is called No Gods or Kings. You can find an excerpt of that on my website, nogodsorkings.com. Until next time, everybody, stay classy.